We're sure you've noticed here in Minnesota, we are being inundated with political ads. Tonight, we turn our attention back to one of the most contentious congressional races in the state between Republican incumbent Eric Paulson and Democrat Dean Phillips.
Ads in their third district race have dominated the Twin Cities airwaves. And tonight, John Croman verifies the latest claims. John?
You know, in a previous verify, we set the record straight on whether Dean Phillips offers health care to his employees at his coffee shop. The answer was yes. Now that he has full-time employees, he does offer them health care. This time, we're looking at two other tack claims, tack ad claims, to see if they stand up to real facts.
Of course.
Democrat Dean Phillips is a political newcomer and businessman challenging five-term Republican incumbent Eric Paulson in Minnesota's 3rd Congressional District. The latest attacks against Phillips stem from his volunteer work on the Allina Health Board.
And another company run by Phillips tried to cut nurses' health and pension benefits.
This claim by the Congressional Leadership Fund is false. Same goes for this one from the Paulson campaign.
As chairman of the board of a healthcare company, Phillips tried to drastically cut health benefits for hardworking nurses.
Phillips served on the Allina Health Board for 6 years and chaired it from 2009 to 2011 for no pay. According to Allina, the board advises on long-term strategy but is not involved in labor negotiations with nurses. The Twin Cities nurses staged a one-day strike in 2010, but the sticking point in that strike was staffing levels, not health benefits. And from the MNA, at no point in 2010 did Minnesota nurses sit down at the negotiating table with Dean Phillips to discuss any part of their contract.
Dean Phillips even has the family millions stashed away in offshore accounts.
This claim from the NRCC is misleading. It's a reference to the J. and Rose Phillips Foundation, a charity created by Dean Phillips' great-grandparents in 1944, which has donated $400 million to community causes, such as Minneapolis Mount Sinai, the Phillips Eye Institute, and the Phillips Wagenstein Medical Building at the U.
So the reference to offshore accounts in that ad creates the false impression that it is some kind of a tax shelter for Dean Phillips personally. But the charities we're talking about here are tax exempt, and they're talking about investments in offshore companies, which is different than hiding them or stashing them in offshore accounts. We're going to see a lot more ads coming in from all sides, local candidates and national political groups on both sides of the aisle, and we'll check them out when we get them.
All right, very helpful. We appreciate it. Yeah, thank you, John.
Thanks, John.